First thing what I am going to do, that is every one of us, what we need to do is whenever we have some issue, the first thing is we have to make up the mind, we have to determine, we have to first recognize which area we are going to, you know, probe for the painful points. Let's say someone has breathing issue, okay, a person is not able to breathe properly, difficulty in breathing, okay. So which is the area we have to look for the painful points? Can you please put it on the chat? Breathing problem, it's very easy. So it is lungs. Yeah, it is lungs over here, right? It is the lung area. So slowly, gently, okay, what I am going to do is I am going to use this probe. This is a probe, okay? So you're going to use the probe by, you know, pressing the points. I got a call here, okay? Just hold on for 1 minute, please. Okay, I'm back. Can you hear me? Can you hear me, people? Yes. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to find all those painful points. Okay, so I'm you know, pressing this area which is under the thumb. Okay, I'm not finding any painful points. Okay, yes, I got one. Okay, so I got a painful point which is extremely painful. I can feel the pain. Okay, so what I'm going to do is let me mark this first. Okay, I'm going to mark this. Okay, I marked this point. Okay, so this is a very or severe painful point. Okay, so this is a primary point. Okay, then I'm going to find other points, other less painful points. Yeah, I got another one over here, just less painful. Okay, so by this way, you know, I'll maybe one will get, a person might get several points. Okay, I'm just putting it randomly over here. Okay, so this most probably, this is the right lung, this is the right lung, this area. Let me draw and show you. So this is the, you know, the right lung, and this is the left lung. Okay, so these are the lungs area, lungs. Okay, so what I'm going to do next is, when I have found the points, the primary point and the secondary points, next step number two is I'm going to give an intense pressure. I should feel that pressure. One should feel that pressure. They should bring that impulse. You know, impulse is very important. We need to bring this out so that the brain goes and activates the sympathetic nervous system and the healing starts. Okay, so just for 10 seconds you have to press nicely so that you feel that pain. Okay, you have to also press on the secondary points as well. Okay, okay. Right, so step two is done. Okay, step three is done. You have pressed all the points, including the, you know, the primary and the secondary points. Step three is done. Now step four is either you're going to use what, magnets. Okay, either you're going to use magnets or the seeds for continuous stimulation for a prolonged treatment. Okay, see these are the four basic steps. So we have already discussed about the contraindications and how much, you know, how long the treatment should be. Okay, basically it should be there, that is, if you are tying your magnet over here, okay, should be there for 12 hours. Okay, you're going to use the tape. Okay, you're going to use the tape, and for every between one and two hours, you're going to press it. You have to press, you know, the seeds or the magnets regularly for giving, you know, regular stimulation. Okay, and then we also discussed that you have to follow, if the problem is chronic, you have to do it for at least 12 to 15 days. You have to continue tying or sticking the magnets or the seeds to get best results if it's a very chronic issue. Okay, so you might be knowing, right, what is chronic and acute issue. If you get some problem, suddenly if you get something, then it's known as acute. When you have something for a longer period of time, for example, someone has asthma for a longer period of time, maybe for 5 to 6 years, that is chronic. Okay, so for that you need what? You need to do lots of courses, okay, so that the problem, really, problem goes away. Okay, so these are the four steps you need to follow. Okay, the first three are the all the four are very important. Okay, so if you want to have good results, then you have to follow all the four steps. Okay, most of the people, they stop at the third step, they don't follow the fourth step. That is, they give pressure or they give needles, right? They insert needles, then they leave it. Okay, that is not correct, and that will not give you best results. See, there is one option. That is, when you give pressure, either you can give pressure or you can use needles. Okay, you can use needles. Okay, both of these two techniques you are going to use for a brief period of time. That is, you are going to give pressure just for 2 to 3 minutes. When you are inserting a needle, then you are going to keep that needle only for a few minutes. You are going to take it out later, okay, and you are going to throw it in the dustbin. Okay, later the fourth step which you are going to do, the magnets or the seeds, that is going to stay for a longer period of time. Okay, right? Okay, so let me summarize. Let me open up that slide and show to you. Let me present that. Okay, I'm presenting my screen over here. Okay, so those who have come late, we just started and we discussed the four steps. Okay, the four steps which are needed for treatment. Okay, so these are the four steps. Step number one, perform proper diagnosis and locate the correct respondent's zone. Okay, so this is the very important thing. Okay, so for example, someone has diarrhea, then they have to concentrate, they have to focus on either on the, the spleen region or the intestine region, mainly the large intestine. Okay, that we'll discuss inshallah. Okay, so instead of focusing on these organs, if you are focusing on other organs, you might not get the proper results. Okay, step number two, you have to use the probe and you have to find the most painful, that is the primary point, and also other less painful secondary points in the main corresponding system, or you can also find it in the insect system. Okay, but mostly people, they don't use the insect system. They find good results in the main corresponding system itself. Step three, then you have what? You need to stimulate the painful points, both the primary as well as the secondary points, with the use of an acupressure jimmy rod. Okay, so this jimmy is nothing other than the same probe which I just showed you in the video. Okay, so you're going to use that probe, that is the jimmy, or you're going to insert the needles. And the fourth step, the most important step for continuous stimulation, you have to apply either the magnets or the seeds, or you can combine seeds with colors or magnets with colors on the correspondent zone or channels for continuous stimulation. If you have any doubts, you can ask me over here. So no doubts until here, right? So we can proceed. Is there any doubts? Yes, we can use two types of treatments at the same time, no problem. We can use the insect one plus the main correspondence, okay? That's not a problem, that's not an issue. When you use two systems at one time, inshallah you'll get very good results. The question is, for organs that occur in pair, such as the lungs, do the corresponding hands have the corresponding points, treatment points? Good question. Let me address that. Yeah, so to enhance your treatment, you need to consider these two things. Number one, you need to choose the correct side. For those organs which are on the right side of the body, you have to give treatment on the right side, sorry, on the right hand. And for those organs which are at the left side of the body, you need to give the treatment on the left hand. For example, your liver is on your right side. So if you want to give treatment to the liver, you have to give it to the right hand of your body and right leg, that is right foot of your body. Another example is heart. Heart is slightly tilted towards the left side. So for the heart, you have to give treatment on the left hand and the left foot. Okay, so when you do this, you'll get best results, inshallah. And number two step or point which you need to be very concerned of is you need to use the maximum correspondence systems. That is, if you apply magnet